As we saw in lecture 32, with smart guides you can quickly align elements. But when you have to align multiple elements, align and distribute is a real time saver. I go to Windows, Align and Distribute. Let's say, I want this image to be horizontally in the middle of the gray background. I click on the gray background, and then on the image. We see that the image will be aligned to the item I selected first, which was the background. I click on Center on Vertical Axis. Now let's say, I want these circles to be at the same height, but the blue circle has to stay in place, it is not supposed to move. To do this, I first select all circles. Then I hold Shift, to exclude the blue circle from the selection. Again, I shift-click on the blue circle, to add it again to the selection. Now the blue circle, is the last selected item. So I choose, relative to last selected. If I now align the circles, the blue circle will stay in position. Now let's say, I want this circle to be placed exactly in the center of the page. I choose, relative to page. I click on center on vertical axis, and center on horizontal axis. I can also center the circle relative to the margins. Now let's say, I want these circles to be evenly distributed from the left margin to the right margin. With relative to margin selected, I set the green circle to the left margin, and the black circle to the right margin. Then I select them all, and choose, selection. With selection, I can determine where in the bounding box the circles will be placed. If I click on align tops, all circles will be placed to the top of the bounding box, which is the position of the highest circle. I press Ctrl Z to undo. Likewise, if I click on align bottoms, the circles will be placed to the bottom of the bounding box, which is the position of the lowest circle. And when I click on center on horizontal axis, the circles will be placed in the center of the bounding box, so in the middle or halfway the box. To distribute the circles evenly, I click on the distribute tab. I click on make horizontal gaps between items equal. I group the result, so I don't accidentally move a circle. Here, I want the top images to be placed against the top margin. I drag over the four top images to select them. In the Align tab, I choose, relative to margins. The Align Tops pictogram visually shows what it will do. It will align the top of the images, to the top margin. I want the images to have a specific space between them. I choose, relative to selection. I click on the Distribute tab. Here I can give in the distance I want, between the images. Then I click on, make horizontal gaps between items equal, to the value specified. I will group the images, to make them one item. I select the images below, and distribute them. I click on the Align tab, and on Align Tops. And I group the images. I hold Shift, and also select the group above. To align the two groups, I click on the Align Left Sides icon. I also want a specific space, between the two groups. I click on the Distribute tab. I give in the distance I want between the groups. I click on, make vertical gaps between items equal, to the value specified. I right mouse click, and choose group, to get a single group. Now let's align the group to a guide that I have placed. I click on the guide I want to align to. I choose, relative to guide, and click on align left sides.